knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
As we've seen in previous tutorials, the evolution of the study of logic developed much like arithmetic, from a simplistic substitution of words into variables toward complex calculi with increasing degrees of specificity and precision. Last time, we saw how to translate both ordinary language and the classical Aristotelian logic into the post-Fregean predicate logic using a few examples while explaining what the most common symbols mean. In this tutorial, we'll get into more depth with the concepts behind this form of writing, and this format of logical thought itself, and how they compare to previous formats. Though, to the average person, this all just seems like a very complicated manner of representing our simple everyday language, these are the fundamental building blocks which allowed for space travel, medicine, and the very engineering and programming of the device you're using to watch this video. Let's go back to some of those symbols. We saw that parentheses aggregate sentences and indicate that whatever is inside them must be solved before progressing to the rest of the inference, among other things. First, when we represent myself as the capital Y for YouTuber and a minor D for Dave, YD, we are actually simplifying the presupposed parentheses. Indeed, our common example, for all X, YX, then MX, could be written this way. The usage of parentheses, however, is not mandatory and is used to better visually represent sentences. Some conventions are used to avoid them, like the Polish notation, which eliminates the need for any parentheses whatsoever, with our inference becoming this. Also, a simple convention of order of operations can be used, akin to arithmetic. Negations are solved first, then conjunctions and disjunctions, followed by the quantifiers, and lastly, implications and equivalences. Another use for the parentheses is to symbolize a blank space where a variable could be inserted. If we take the "Dave is a YouTuber" sentence, it is represented by YD when the parentheses are written. While D stands for Dave, then Y parentheses stands for parentheses is a YouTuber. In this case, we can call D the logical subject of our argument, and Y parentheses, or just Y, our logical predicate, or the function of the argument. Dave is a YouTuber, or YD, would be a sentence with a defined value. With this understanding, we can then categorize sentences into simple or complex. Sentences are simple when, after our analysis of it, we can only separate it into logical subjects and predicates. Therefore, Dave is a YouTuber, YD, would be a simple sentence because we have only the subject Dave, D, and the predicate, parentheses is a YouTuber, Y. Complex sentences, on the other hand, require at least two steps to reach only these simplest elements, with the previous ones revealing other sentences. When we look at the sentence, "All YouTubers are mortal," as we've seen previously, it is actually more accurately read as, "Regarding every X, if X is a YouTuber, then X is mortal," akin to a mathematical formula. As we analyze it, clearly there are two simple sentences that it is composed of, "X is a YouTuber, YX, and X is mortal, MX," connected by a material implication. But contrary to classical term logic, we can analyze the same sentence in multiple ways. Returning to Dave is a YouTuber, there are three manners in which we can understand it. First, as we saw just now, Dave as a subject and parentheses is a YouTuber as a predicate. But we can also consider YouTuber as a subject and Dave is parentheses as the predicate, if we'd like to shift the focus of our analysis. Finally, we can take both Dave and YouTuber as subjects and parentheses is parentheses as a predicate. If we were to take a complex sentence such as Dave is a YouTuber that explains chemistry, we can see three possible variables. Dave is a YouTuber that explains chemistry, which would lead to seven possible interpretations, broken down just like the previous example. One, with Dave as a subject and parentheses is a YouTuber that explains chemistry as the predicate. Two, Dave and explains chemistry as subjects, and parentheses is a YouTuber that parentheses as a predicate. 3. Dave and a YouTuber as subjects, and parentheses is parentheses that explains chemistry as a predicate. 4. Dave, a YouTuber, and explains chemistry as subjects, and parentheses is parentheses that parentheses as a predicate. 5 explains chemistry as the subject and Dave is a YouTuber that parentheses as a predicate. 6 a YouTuber and explains chemistry as subjects and Dave is parentheses that parentheses as a predicate. And 7 a YouTuber as subject and Dave is parentheses that explains chemistry as the predicate. We could already know that the first example would yield 3 possibilities, and the second example would yield 7 if given the following formula, 2 to the n minus 1, where n is the number of blanks to be filled. Thus, the first example yields 3 combinations, since 2 to the 2 minus 1 equals 3, and the second one yields 7, since 2 cubed minus 1 equals 7. This versatility is the reason that predicate logic was able to subsume both term logic and propositional logic into one system, giving nuance to the analysis of terms and of propositions as a whole at the same time. Term logic, as with classical logic, is limited to intra-sentential analysis. So you could only verify how well it realistically represents reality, what would be called its quantification of existence, by how accurate to the real world its own inferences can be, also known as true instances. Propositional logic is also limited, but to inter-sentential analysis, where individual sentences can join together to form a single one. As we said before, predicate logic is a more nuanced manner of utilizing the strengths of both of these previous models, and we've shown the greater depth it provides to its term counterpart. But what does it mean to improve propositional logic? Let's take our argument. Every YouTuber is mortal. Dave is a YouTuber. Thus, Dave is mortal. Now let's compare that with every YouTuber is mortal. Every dog is mortal. Thus, every dog is a YouTuber. Though the first inference is true, and the second obviously false, and we can demonstrate this using set theory, propositional logic reaches a standstill. Representing both sentences, we arrive at P, Q, thus R, which means both are equally false, as R is not present in any of the propositions before the conclusion. Predicate logic solves this as it can analyze and represent both the propositions and their terms with much greater detail. One manner in which it can utilize both intra- and inter-sentential analysis is this. Dave is a YouTuber. Dave explains chemistry. Thus, some YouTubers explain chemistry. We can represent this with first-order symbols as follows. As the first two sentences affirm, there is at least one person, in this case me, Dave, who is both a YouTuber and explains chemistry. But there could be more, contrary to an exclusive particular affirmation, which would limit the entire universe of people who could be both to just myself. Two sentences conjoin in a conclusion, and true instances are existentially quantified, more than 2,000 years of separate logical paradigms condensed into one simple argument. This concludes our introduction to contemporary logic for the moment. Hopefully, this has clarified to some degree the manner in which contemporary logic is capable of condensing the best and most efficient elements of classical logic, propositional logic, and arithmetic toward one of the most elemental and elegant manners of representing natural language, a goal only possible after more than 2,000 years of philosophy and mathematics. In the next tutorial, we will take a look at how we can apply logic to our everyday argumentation in a more practical manner by studying what fallacies are and how to identify and deal with them.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.